Let's see if this G-Shock is as strong as they say it is. Let's put it to the test. I have a little test here to do with this beautiful watch. Watch closely. Nah, just kidding. Let's just talk about the watch. Look at my ears.
So no, I don't have questions about durability of this watch. I believe this G-Shock or any other G-Shock is way stronger than you would really need in real life. It's just that kind of ease of mind having a super strong watch on your wrist that you can trust and smash around in some kind of a construction site and be just completely fine that it's gonna survive through everything. And it will. I have no doubts about that. I have other doubts, however. You see, previously I had another G-Shock which was marketed to do something very specific. That was GBD-100. It was marketed as a fitness watch, but it turned out that it doesn't even have a proper stopwatch. A fitness watch that doesn't have a proper stopwatch. That was a total failure in my opinion. The link in the description if you wanna see the review of that watch. That was just a fashion watch, fashion G-Shock. Now, we have yet another G-Shock which is marketed to do something specific. This watch is marketed for construction site workers and such. So, you know what, I have just one very important test for this watch. I don't have questions about durability. The readability of the watch is very good, even in dim light. We'll talk about that later on. But there is one very important test. You see, these gloves are not even heavy-duty gloves. They are rubberized gloves. They are not fabric. This is rubberized gloves that are completely covered in cat hair. Anyway, so the test is, can I actually use these buttons with these gloves? Now listen. Okay. You know what? It gets a pass from me. And there is another very important thing. You know, you work hard, manual labor, sweating for the money. The watch has to be very comfortable. And with this G-Shock, you know, it's big. It tends to get in the way a little bit, but whatever, you can get used to that. What's bigger problem though, is that, for example, the first time I put this watch on the wrist, it was like, wow, man, this is one of the most comfortable G-Shocks I ever had. It feels just wonderful. It just hugs the wrist so nicely and so soft. Amazing. But 1 hour later, I started noticing, sorry, my cat's going crazy. 1 hour later, I started noticing one thing that I just can't get the perfect fit. The gap between these holes is too big. It's either too tight or too loose for me. And these holes are finished in such a nice way, it would be really a shame to puncture an extra hole. I wouldn't be able to make it such nice a hole. And another thing, you see, you work in construction site or something like that, manual labor, sweating hard and such. And you see, this watch has 24 millimeter wide strap, which is not very breathable either. And the watch itself is also a huge chunk of material on the wrist. The hand gets very sweaty very quickly. And if you work in an environment where are a lot of dust, so the dust together with sweat gets under the watch, under the strap, it's gonna be nasty. It's gonna irritate your skin quite a lot. So no, working in nasty environments with strap of 24 millimeters wide, which is not breathable either, no, that's no good. But there is a nice thing that these straps are easy to take off, and there are different kind of straps to buy for this watch. So, I don't know, maybe you can find some kind of an option which would be breathable and a lot more comfortable, because this original one feels wonderful just first hour on the wrist if you're not doing anything physical. Once you get sweaty, this watch gets nasty underneath. Okay, now I want to talk about some functions of the watch, show you it a little bit up close, how it looks like. Speaking about this little LCD screen, well, It's digital analog watch, so you know, more or less it's a little bit of a gimmick. Like right now, the watch can only show you day, can show you month and date, but it will show you day only several hours later, because right now hands are just blocking the view half of the screen. But no worries, this is newer G-Shock model, so you can actually move these hands out of the way. The way to do it is press light button and then menu button. Not so very convenient, but eventually those hands will get out of the way and you can see the screen. And now, if you wanna go to the menu, while you scroll to the menu, hands still gonna go back to the place. But there is very interesting quirky thing. You see this little square on the top right? It does actually show you in which menu section you are currently at. Stopwatch, like this is main screen, timer, vault timer, alarm, stopwatch. So even though hands are blocking the view, you still know where you're at, which is kind of helpful sometimes. So for example, let's go to the alarm. And if you want to set the alarm, yeah, like on all watches, just hold this button a little bit. And that is enough to move these hands out of the way. You don't need to do that combo. The watch knows that you want to set the alarm and move those hands out of the way. So, okay, let's say I set the alarm anyway. There is another very interesting quirky thing which I would like to show you. Let's go to the main screen. This is main screen. And I wish all watches would have this kind of a function. You see, all I need to start a stopwatch is press this button. That's it. I don't need to go into menus to find a stopwatch to start the stopwatch. This is very convenient. Yeah, main screen, start a stopwatch. Here you go. It's so good. I wish more watches would have it. Really, really good function. Right now I want to show you how strong is the backlight. So let me close the door. And look, I can actually use the backlight of the watch as some kind of a torch. I can illuminate myself and make scary faces. So it actually is helpful because, well, later on I'll show you the angle it shines. So you can actually use it as a torch to illuminate a keyhole, simply to get the key in the keyhole when you come late at night. Look, the light is shining right from this corner. So when I turn on the light, it shines like to this direction, so it's very easy. You know, you come next to the door, this is keyhole, I just press the light and you see, I can actually use it as a torch, as a flashlight, which is very handy. Okay, this is all I wanted to show you. Of course, there are a lot more things going deeper into menus, into functions, etc. But, you know, I just wanted to give you the general sense of the watch, how it is as a watch. You see, the design is definitely not for everyone. I believe it's meant a little bit towards a younger audience. I don't hate this watch, but it somehow doesn't get me excited. I look at it as some kind of a kid's toy. No offense though, it's just, I'm just telling the feelings I'm getting from this watch. You know those toys that kids play with and the whole floor is completely covered with kids' toys. If this was laying down together with kids' toys on the floor somewhere, I just wouldn't even notice this watch. It's, I don't know, doesn't give me any emotions somehow. But it's completely subjective, completely personal thing. You can love it, you can hate it, doesn't matter. It's still a good watch. So talking about my website, thomaswatchreviews.com, where I rate watches into different tier lists, this watch goes into not bad. Because, you know, it checks the main things. Time is easy to see. The watch is very durable, very reliable, and very accurate. I mean, that's it. It's not a bad watch. So that's where it goes. Not bad. Anyway, thank you for watching. Have a beautiful day. Goodbye.